Am I audible? Hello. Hello. Am I audible? Are you guys able to hear me?
Yes.
Okay. So we'll start today's class back in next straight. And gently close your eyes. And start watching your breath. Disconnecting from the past and the future. And coming back to your breath. Allowing it to settle to the natural rhythm. And making sure that your forehead, neck, and shoulders are completely relaxed. Now begin to deepen your breath. Inhale deeply. Then hold for 2 seconds. And then exhale deeply. Taking a few breaths in this format. Inhaling completely. And then pausing. And then exhaling completely. We'll be chanting Om 3 times, followed by 3 shantis. Inhale deeply for Om. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Just feel the vibrations. Join both your palms together in front of your chest and rub both the palms together. Place them over your eyes. Slowly while blinking and looking at your palms, come back. And namaste to everyone. So wishing each and every one of you present over here a very happy International Day of Yoga. It's 21st June today, and it's the 7th International Day of Yoga that we are celebrating. So it's a really good thing. Like for the past 7 years, it's now the 7th year that we're celebrating it. So we hope that with time, yoga is spread more and more, like through all of these classes, and keep yoga in your life in one way or the other. Yeah, try to do that. Get it into your daily practice in some way or the other. It might be just your breath or might be just your asana practice. Anything would do. Yeah. Okay. So in the last class, I gave a homework noting down your activity and seeing which one falls in which category. Yeah. So someone, have you done that homework? Hello. Okay. If not, it's okay. You can still work on it. Okay. So today we are going to play this game, which is a self game basically. So basically, you have to. I'll tell you what you have to do, and then just unmute and tell me the five things basically, that like five or six things, whatever I'm asking you to observe. So it's basically a very common grounding activity. So we'll start with five things that you can see. Okay. So you can unmute yourself and tell me five things that you can see right now in front of you.
Should I go?
Yeah.
Yeah, laptop, books, mm-hmm. then photo frame, mirror, mm-hmm. water jug.
Nice. Who's going next? Okay, I'll go next. Okay, I can see a t-shirt, almira, curtains, chair, and table. Okay, great. We'll move to the next category. So whichever category suits you, you can unmute yourself and participate accordingly. Okay. So any four things that you can touch around you? Okay, I'll go first. I can touch my phone, yeah. Bed sheet, okay. My hair and my t-shirt.
Similar,
what
like
is the game actually?
The game is that I'm giving you a certain category of things, like, and you have to tell me. If you can, like, you have to name those things. So, like, first we did five things that you can see around you, then four things that you can, like, touch around you. So, who wants to go next?
It's almost same. Whatever I can see, I'm also able to touch. So, my list is same.
Okay. Jagruti ji. Do you want to share?
Only both we can see and we can touch.
Okay.
It should be both.
No. Just something that you can feel. Like I can touch my hair. Yeah. My t-shirt. Something like that. Yeah. So four things.
Okay. Pen, book, plant, window, wall.
Okay. Nice. Anybody else who would like to participate? I can see Simran, Akanksha, Ashwita ji, Asmita ji. Anybody else who would want to unmute themselves and participate? Please feel free.
I can.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, I can touch the laptop, phone, yoga mat, and the sofa.
Okay, very nice. Okay, so your next category is three things that you can hear. So I'll go first in this. Okay, I can hear the fan. Yeah, I can hear all of you guys. And I can hear a bike passing by over here.
Okay. Birds around me. Sorry. Birds' voice. My maid doing work, that voice. Mm-hmm. And vehicle noise outside my house.
Okay.
I can hear some chants going in the ashram. Mm-hmm. Then fan. And then you guys.
Okay. Simran, do you want to go next?
I can hear you. I can hear the sound of the fan. And then my mother is sending messages on WhatsApp. So that sound also I can hear.
Awesome. Anybody else?
Hi, Soumya. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, I can hear you. I can hear my watch ticking. I can hear my husband walking by. Yeah.
Okay. So two things that you guys can smell. So I can smell the detergent because the bed sheet was recently washed. Yeah. And I can smell the breakfast that is being cooked.
Okay, I can smell mud smell because last day it was raining. So another smell is that cow dung, which is lying outside my garden.
Okay. Who's going next?
Okay, I can smell my face cream because I just applied before class. And... yeah, just because I'm sitting in a garden, probably the fresh air.
Okay, awesome. Next. Okay, I'll go with the last category, one emotion that you can feel. So I can feel, I'm feeling, I would say, I'm confused.
Yeah, sorry. I feel very energetic today because maybe International Yoga Day. I am looking forward to attend all the classes today.
Okay, awesome.
I have no idea. This one I was curious.
My connection is broke, I think. Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Yeah.
Your voice is breaking.
Okay. My network connection was poor, I think, 4 days.
Okay.
तो मुझे डर है कि आज भी वो सपोज पुअर रहेगा तो मेरे क्लासेस मिस होंगे.
No worries. हाँ, बताओ. Anybody else who would like to share?
I'm feeling awakened because of this exercise.
Okay, चलो. So we had another activity for the day. Okay, so now we'll start our class. Okay, so let me see. I'm not able to see my icons today somehow. So So I'll just share my screen and then we'll start the class. Okay. I'll just use the Wi-Fi. Okay, so last time we were discussing Ashtanga Yoga. Okay, so in Ashtanga Yoga, we are going to discuss each and every limb separately. So we'll start with Yama or okay, so the first thing that comes in Ashtanga Yoga is Yama. So I'll write down the five Yamas that we have. Ahimsa or non-violence. Satya or truth. And third, we have Satya. Then we have non-possessiveness. Aste or non-stealing. And last we have Brahmacharya or sexual abstinence. Okay. So these are the five yamas that we have. Okay. So basically, when you start with yogic practices, Patanjali ji saw that first it was very important for you to understand how you have to conduct yourself in the society. Because he understood that for a beginner, he wouldn't like leave the society initially. So he must understand, he or she must understand how to conduct himself or herself in the society. Okay, so he gave five yamas. So both yamas and niyamas also help you to, in a way, gain mental strength to go into the next limbs of yoga, the next limbs that he has given. Okay, so it's also like helping you to develop a lot of mental strength basically. Okay, so we start with ahimsa or non-violence. Okay, so you do not hurt or harm anyone around you or anything around you. Okay, so that is what he meant by ahimsa. So it should not just be in action, like for a beginner, yes, we can stop harming the environment or make our own small contribution to uplift the environment. Yeah, but on a very deep level, even the thoughts that we have of violence or of hurting someone else, yeah, should go away. Like with the practices of yoga, we should aim to get over there where now are like there are no violent thoughts also crossing us, because it's very obvious, and maybe it's not very obvious, but it is very well known that when a thought comes up, that is when the thought gets converted into action and speech. It's not the other way around. Like, yes, your action and speech will give you a thought, but actually, like, if we realize it or not realize it, like first there is a thought, maybe we're not aware of it. Yeah, sometimes we're not aware of that thought, but that thought will always precede your action or whatever your words. Yeah, so on a deeper level, ahimsa should come on these levels also. And a person who deeply practices ahimsa will also see that things that generally have a nature of attacking one another. For example, like if there is a lion and a deer, okay? And if the yogi is passing by that place, yeah. So what will happen is even their inherent nature of attacking each other would turn around. That is the level of non-violence till which the yogi goes. Yeah, that things that are naturally bound to, like, it's a food cycle, no? that the lion will attack the deer to feed itself. But even that stops and they become friendly in front of a yogi. So that is the deep level till which you should aim to achieve non-violence. Yeah. Okay. But for a beginner, at least start with certain things that you can change in your life, which you know will not harm the things around you. Okay. Then we move to satya or truth. Okay. So this is another thing that you develop. Yeah. With time. It's very easy to lie. And it is very natural to lie, okay? Because we cannot always say the truth. For example, if I'm interacting with someone, it's not necessary that if I'm asked a particular question, I would be truthful about it. Why should I be? Like, yeah, right. But that's the whole point, like when we talk of these things, of being truthful, that it isn't about the other person or the person I'm interacting with. It's about myself, yeah? If I am not telling the truth, it's like I have my own separate account in the bank, basically. Okay. So whatever I put in, that will come out. Yeah. Input will give me that output. So it isn't about what situation I am in or which person I'm interacting with. It's the fact that I have to tell the truth no matter what. Okay. On a very basic level, on a very day-to-day level, at least what we can do is we can reduce the number of lies. Yeah. So if I cannot like totally focus on telling the truth all the time, at least I can reduce the intensity of my lie. Initially, I was lying about like everything and anything. Now, at least the frequency would reduce. Or maybe I was lying about a really big thing. Like, okay, so I want to get out of my house. So I lie to my father that I'm going and like going for studying. So now at least I can like reduce that lie and at least tell him ki thoda padhai karne ke liye ja rahi hu aur baad mein hang out bhi karunga doston ke sath. So maine thoda baant diya us cheez ko practically. Initial level par even this is okay. We have to start somewhere. You cannot go from 0 to 100, but you can go from 0 to 10. So I can at least doing that, start doing that to get into that process. Once I am able to build inertia in that process, pehle main thoda sa momentum build karungi us cheez mein, fir main fully jaungi. Theek hai? So to build that momentum, I will start breaking down things. I will start seeing on what level I am lying or telling the truth. Okay. And it's a self-observatory thing. You know, nobody will come and tell you ki tumne jhoot bola. You lied. Nobody will come and tell you. It's just your inner voice which will come and tell you, ki nahin, this time I did not tell the truth. You know, I wasn't exactly honest over here. Okay. So next we have apigraha or non-possessiveness. So sorry for the slip. Yes, Omkarji.
Yeah, so here the in Patanjali Yoga Sutra, the satya truth is always they describe it as a combination of truth and what is actually needed for that situation, right? It's not always categorized as you should tell the truth. Like they give example of like when somebody is coming to you for hurting a cow and he's asking for your direction. So you should not tell the direction, like you are lying there, but it's actually saving the cow. So I just wanted to know that at what extent this is should be done, and like, or should we always means stick to something, or what extent this is correct?
So I think for a beginner level, Why am I saying? Like it's a very like how you perceive it kind of situation. Like as far as I could understand from your question, like how you are perceiving that thing. Like let me add a twist to this story.
Let me give you another example. Like you said, right, that you are living suppose you are living for long term and the purpose is not good. So you're directly telling your parents that suppose I'm taking sannyas and something like that. So that too can harm them for long term, their disease, anything, heart attack can come. But if you care, if you give them some false idea at start, but so slowly, slowly you give them idea and you can try to convince them, though, so that is good for them also and for you also. So in this sense you are lying, but that lie lies beneficial for them also and for you also.
That is what I said. You can't jump from 0 to 100. So for a beginner, you will start like that only. Like, dheere dheere digest karna padta hai kuch cheezon ko. Like, not everybody, like when you say the truth, will be able to digest it. So you need to understand ki kahan par kis hisab se aapko deal karna. Ek ye, this is a very, like, I'm talking on a very practical level. This is a life skill that you develop over time. This is what a guru sees when they see their student. Like, so if I just like, that is why Gyan Yoga is so tough, because it will directly tell you the truth without understanding if you are ready for it or not. That is why a guru is so important. So, wahi wali baat hai. All of this is very subjective. Okay. So you can play around with these things. You can think ki maybe on a law, like on in, like if I think that in your example only, that if I don't give the right direction to that person or don't tell the direction to that person, so I'm directly assuming that I'm the only one there to give the direction, and two, that if I don't get the direction, that person will not reach that place or, to perform whatever activity they want to perform. Theek hai, toh bada, it's very subjective, and you cannot like put it into a box and factorize it. That is why I said that whenever you're speaking the truth or the lie, you know. So aap apne sath account settle karo. Like, rather than seeing the external situation, at least on a beginner level, like you settle your account with yourself. You understand how to manage that situation. I'm not telling you to manipulate that situation. There is a difference. Okay. Not everybody can hear very strong or deep truths. Okay.
So can we say that? Can we say that the truth that is said with non-selfish purpose? Or you can say the false or lie that said with non-selfish purpose or good purpose cannot be categorized as a lie. At the start, at least.
See, once again, it's a very subjective question. This is a very subjective thing as per my understanding. So, truth, first thing. So we discussed when we were discussing vritti. So we can only perceive a modification of the truth. So right knowledge mil rahi hai aapko. But truth kya hai? Wo, jab aap us level pe jaoge, when you will reach that level, that is when your understanding of these things will like go up. Like, आप अपने आप समझ पाओगे इन चीजों को. सो लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल इन दिस केस ओनली, वेर यू वर लाइक इफ समबडी लाइक विद अ गुड इंटेंशन ओनली. तो एक योगी, अ योगी नेवर मेडल्स विद द नेचुरल लॉ. ठीक है, ही नोज दैट ही कैन, ही हैज द एबिलिटी, बट ही वोंट. ये डिफरेंस हो जाता है दोनों चीजों में, कि आई नो दैट आई कैन डू समथिंग, but I'm choosing not to do it because it will go against the law of nature. So isme keh sakte ho, if that is the fate or the destiny of that thing, like it has to happen. Yeah, so usme aapka, your contribution is like bhai main keh rahi hu, aap apne sath settle karte ho sabse zyada. Is it a little bit more clear? Like, yeah. see when I'll become a yogi, I will let you know if lying for a good purpose is good or not. Right now, personally, I do not think that it is, like, because if I'm not able to be authentic, like, then it really disturbs me. Yeah. So main apni authenticity ko fight nahi kar sakti, like my own being. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. So we'll move to the next. Non-possessiveness, yeah. So, so I'll give you an example to explain this yama. Okay, so what happens is that a few days back, my sister came to me and she was just like, okay, chalo, aapko donate karne kapde. You have to give away some clothes because I'm going to this NGO donation camp, and so take out, go check your closet and take out clothes. So I was just like, okay, I'll go and I'll get everything that I'm not using to you because it's not relevant for me. Yeah. So I went to my closet and then Then I was looking around, and then I was like checking all of my clothes. I was just like, okay, so now I have to give this away. So my mind started playing games with me. I was just like, is color ki to ye t-shirt hai. This is the only t-shirt that I have with this color. Okay, so let me not give this away. Okay, I looked for reasons to keep everything that I did not need. Basically, that is what I was doing because I was so attached to it. Okay, so then I kept like another t-shirt because ek hi polo hai, theek hai? Then I kept another one, ek hi shirt hai is color mein. Okay, so I was giving myself what reasons to not part with things that I wasn't needing. Okay, and what will happen is once I will go to travel somewhere, so I will just carry those 5 t-shirts. Out of those 5 t-shirts, I will only wear 2 t-shirts because those 2 are my favorite. So do I need all the 5? I don't. But there is this attitude of being, of possessing everything. And in today's world, it is absolutely existent because we live in a very fast-paced and immediately gratifying world. Okay, so if I place an order on Amazon, I know that the next day it will come here. Prime membership le li, aa gaya. It is coming home. So there is a lot of, and once it comes in, I get very attached to those things, even though I don't need them. So finally, what happened? I came back with only a few t-shirts, and my sister gave me this look, and she was just like, kya? Matlab, you're donating something, and I know you have ample t-shirts, so what are you doing? So I just looked at her, and that really gave me a very like a deep thought in that moment that I do not need most of the things that I'm trying to hold on to. Yeah, but my mind is taking out reasons to still have them. So developing this attitude of non-possessiveness is very important. Anything and everything that you have around you, which you do not need, yeah, is somewhere reinforcing your sense of possessiveness towards those things. You are trying to have things which you do not need. So unki jab need nahi hai, to dheere dheere karke what starts happening is, because we don't need them and we acquire them, there's a lot of sense of attachment that we feel towards them. And when we have to like let go of those things, we are not. Like I see so many times, like my father, okay, and he is attached to a lot of things because like those things were there in his childhood, and every time we are just like, okay, let's clean up the house and let's like give these things away. He has this, like he is unable to do that. Yeah. And I see the same thing in me also. Like I'm unable to let go of certain things, even though I don't need them. So this attitude of the mind, this endless desire or this sense of attachment is giving all of us what a sense, a very great deal of suffering, which we don't even realize because mai ko possess karne ki bahut zyada ichha ho rahi hai us cheez ko. So as soon as like, suppose my father decides ki ab ye to bahar de dena tumne, I'm not letting this stay in my house. Okay. So I feel so sad. I feel like he is not respecting my emotions, or he is not, being considerate of them. But he is. He is understanding that it's just that I don't need it, and maybe someone else needs it. Yes. So, this is the mental attitude that you eventually have to develop, where you are what non-possessive of the things around you. So, उस चीज़ से क्या होता है? Ego नीचे आती है. Your ego goes down. Yeah. Your sense of compassion goes up when you get into a non-possessive attitude. Okay. Next is stealing. So, aste or non-stealing. Okay. So, stealing also, like, there is a desire behind it. Okay. So, us desire ki baat ho rahi hai yahan pe. Stealing is something that you are doing on an action level. Maine kisi ki cheez utha li. But the desire or emotion that is being developed inside of me is something that I need to keep in check. Because if I don't have a sense of this thing, like that I want to take something away which does not again belong to me, to fir wo kya cheez dikha raha hai? Aapka mental attitude. It's showing your mental attitude. So I'll take a very simple example. It happens like a lot around us. So little kids, Okay. And they're very fascinated by colors, and they're very fascinated by everything that is around them because they're just learning about the world right now. So what happens is they go like school jaate hain, yeah, bacche. So they go to the school and they see other kids. And so I remember we used to have partners, yeah. Ek side mein ek baithte the. So what happens is that one of them finds the sharpener very attractive of their partner. So unknowingly, that kid will do what? That kid will take up that sharpener and sharpen his pencil, yeah. And then mistake, it's a mistake only. I'm not saying it's intentional. But understand that it happens on that deep level also, okay? And that kid just keeps that sharpener in their own pencil box. So yahan pe kya ho raha hai? Uska matlab, he's not able to understand at that point of time that he is engaging in an activity where something doesn't belong to him. And because he's fascinated by it, he's just picking it up and keeping it with him. Yeah. So ये जो स्टीलिंग का एटीट्यूड है ये ऑन अ किड लेवल लाइक ऑन अ वेरी लाइक आई कैन से अ टेंडर एज वी लाफ इट ऑफ और वी थिंक दैट ओके आई मीन लाइक इट्स क्यूट समटाइम्स वी से इट्स क्यूट बट यही चीज आगे जाकर डेवलप होती है दिस थिंग इंक्रीजेस विद टाइम एंड इट टेक्स यू टू अ पॉइंट वेयर नाउ यू आर नॉट एबल टू फंक्शन प्रॉपरली इन द सोसाइटी बिकॉज नाउ दैट इज द मेंटल एटीट्यूड दैट यू हैव डेवलप्ड. Okay, so you need to reverse that. You need to come in an attitude where you understand that I do not have to take something which is not mine, at least not without permission. Permission is very important. Ab main batakar le rahi hu kisi ko, I'm telling you that, okay, I'm borrowing this and I will return it. So it's okay. Or maybe somebody is giving it to me. It's okay. But when I take it without permission, that becomes a problem. Okay, so you need to reverse this mental attitude. Then we go to the last point in Yama, okay? Brahmacharya or sexual abstinence. Did I write this spelling right? Abstinence. S-T-I. Sorry. This is A-B-S-T-I. A-B-S-T-I. Sexual abstinence. Yep. Sorry. Now I don't know how to remove this because I guess this is the first time I'm using the whiteboard. Okay. I'll just write it down over here. Okay. So sexual abstinence. So this is very important in the practice of yoga. Okay, so for a single person they say that it has to be complete sexual abstinence. Okay, but in case of a married person, it's said that you just have to engage with your partner. Okay, and even on a thought level, like that doesn't come up. Okay, what is happening over here? So what is happening over here is, like, let me explain you the reason for Brahmacharya, because like a lot of people question this and they're just like, we're not going into this, you know. And they're right, because the sexual desire is really hard to get rid of. It is like a desire which remains with you till a very high stage in your yogic practice. Okay, so there are only two ways in which energy can travel. For the sake of simplicity, I am only using two directions. Okay, down or up. Okay, so why sexual abstinence is because when you indulge in sexual activities, then what happens is that same energy goes down. Okay, so that same energy is getting out of your body through the downward process. Okay, so what a yogi does is when they engage in sexual abstinence, they conserve that same energy and they give it an upward direction. So yogi ke liye this energy is very important because they can only utilize their energy in two ways. Either they can release it out, yeah, downward force, or they can take it up. So un logo ke liye bahut zyada zaruri hai that you go into sexual abstinence. Okay, so that same energy can now be channeled up and It can help you to liberate yourself from all sufferings. Okay. So these are the five yamas that you generally practice. Like as per Patanjali ji, these are the five yamas that you need to practice when you start your yogic practices. And yamas and niyamas have been given immense importance. Like there are a lot of things that you can just achieve by practicing yamas and niyamas only. Like we think that agar hum ye kar lenge, if we do this or that, then we will get siddhis, or then we will get certain psychic powers, I can say. But that's not the case. If you are able to properly follow yamas and niyamas, then you can attain siddhi even at this stage. Yeah. Okay. Any doubts so far regarding this? No? Okay. So we'll start with niyamas next. So now we understood how to function in a society. Okay. Now, the second thing that you need to work on is on your own self. Okay. So how do I conduct myself in order to be in a yogic attitude? Because once I develop this yogic attitude, then all the other limbs are supported by these two strong foundations. So the first niyama that we have is Shauch or cleanliness. Then we have Santosh or satisfaction. Then we have okay. So Shauch, Santosh, Tap, Swadhyay, Ishwar Pranidhan. Okay. So the last three we have discussed a lot of times now. Yeah. So I won't elaborate much on these, the last three, but let's start with the first two. Okay. So Shauch, which is cleanliness. So once again, cleanliness, when you are in a yogic practice, then you have to make sure that your body is clean. Not only is your body clean, this translates to a deeper level of cleansing your mind, your thoughts also. Okay, so I'm maintaining my body. I'm doing Shatkarma practice so that all the toxins are released from my body. I'm doing asana practice so that it remains healthy. Yeah, all the toxins are released. Even when you practice asana, then a lot of sweat and all of these things are released from the body. Yeah. So on a physical level, I'm maintaining this, that, okay, physically I'm bathing every day. I'm keeping everything around me clean, because it again triggers a mental, like I can say a mindset, basically. When I'm not in a clean place, I don't feel clean either, right? So ek to ye aapka cleanliness ho gaya, physical level, on a physical level, whatever I'm doing for myself and my surrounding, okay? Then on a second level, it's like the mental level. So now I'm having like, suppose like I have a lot of thoughts during the day. Okay. But majority of them are negative, or maybe they're not that healthy for me. So I have to make sure that I clean those also, because once again, thought will always precede your action. So if I'm not working on cleaning my thoughts, then I'm not able to like function properly even in the society or in my day-to-day life. The thought level will be you are cleaning yourself and getting into a positive attitude, getting into an attitude of everything working for you, and everything being harmonious around you, peaceful around you, happy around you. Okay, so एक योगी को इस चीज पर he has to work because once again when we come to the second point santosh or satisfaction because a yogi realizes that and it's very important for even us to realize that happiness is not a destination it's the journey yeah so if I am not happy right now and if I think that maybe because of some desire being fulfilled I will be happy then I'm not satisfied with what is and I'm looking for what can be so jab tak unless and until you're not able to develop an attitude of satisfaction for what is I don't think that anybody can ever attain their desire and reach that point and be satisfied at that point kyunki satisfaction is a state of mind it's not a state of possession of something okay so generally what happens is I'll give you my example so I'm crazy about books okay so if I have to read some book suppose conventionally I will order that book now once that book comes like till the time I have to wait I don't have Prime membership so it will come in what 3-5-7 days okay so I waited for 3-5-7 days and then the book came and I was really happy before that all of my thoughts were directed my book will come my book will come my book will come and then I will be happy because I want to see that book okay and then when the book comes I'm happy for a while yeah and then maybe I don't even give it ample time to read well I don't read it entirely also I leave that book in between par kya hua that happiness came for a while and then it faded away and then I saw another book and then I ordered another book yeah so what is happening over here is I'm not satisfied with what I have I'm not saying that it is not okay to want other things or desire for other things but you need to understand that if you are not happy right now then there is a high chance that once you achieve that thing eventually its charm would fade away and you will still not be satisfied because you have developed that tendency in the mind of not being satisfied with what you have or what you achieve so it's very important for you to get into the state of mind where you are happy and satisfied with what you have and then aim for what you want okay then we're moving to the next one I'll take all the questions at the end if you have any okay then we move to tap or austerity okay so on a very fundamental level you cannot achieve something that you want to achieve without doing something which you haven't already done okay now I want to achieve maybe chakrasana okay I want to do chakrasana and I'm not like every day I practice forward bending because forward bending is my favorite okay so I do forward bends every day I'm doing all the pre practices and everything will I ever be able to achieve good backward bending if I am working on my forward bends most likely not like yes I'm giving my spine some work but most likely the perfection that I'm looking in chakrasana I won't be able to get there because I haven't put myself in that place where I'm out of my comfort zone so tapas for a beginner level is actually getting out of your comfort zone and sticking to something which you know is not that comfortable for you mereko backward bend nahi pasand I don't like backward bending but if I put in the hard work to do that backward bend I will achieve it because I'm getting out of my comfort zone theek hai on a deeper level it means that you are leaving all of your like material possessions and all of these things you're trying to mentally detach from those things okay then we come to swadhyay or self study so on the practice of yoga it's very important that you keep analyzing yourself you keep understanding where you have reached where you were where you have reached and where you can reach okay all three things you have to see so swadhyay can be done again on two levels one is your own introspection okay like I said where you were where you are and where you can be second is that you can read scriptures you can get all of the knowledge regarding the natural truths that exist and that will help you to advance in your yogic practice. Okay. Last point for the day, Ishwar Pranidhan. A very important and effective practice for dissolving your ego. Once I know that everything that I am doing is dedicated to a higher power or is dedicated to someone or something that I believe in, then I instantly get detached from my results. Okay, so I'm putting in the effort, but then I'm getting detached from the results because my action is surrendered to someone. Okay, so I'm not concerned with the result. I'm only concerned with giving my 100% in whatever I am doing. Yeah. And then achieving that thing. Okay, because I have to do it, because it's like worship. Whatever I do is a sense of worship for that thing. So I am basically detaching from the result, and my ego goes down immensely because of this. Once you start having faith, start believing in someone, then you will see that your sense of attachment to things will definitely go down. So it's a mental attitude that you develop over time. Okay. So these are the five yamas. Once you get established in these things, then you move to the next limb, which we will discuss tomorrow, asana and all the other limbs. Okay. Any doubt so far? Any doubts? Okay, so we'll end the class. Okay, back in next straight. Close your eyes. And allow all the information to seep in. And now take one deep breath, inhale deeply and exhale deeply. We'll chant Om one time, followed by three shantis. Inhale deeply for Om. Join both your palms together in front of your chest and just bow down. Remember any one incident from your past 24 hours that you are grateful for, and say a mental thank you. And now rub both your palms together. Place them over your eyes. And slowly, while blinking and looking at your palms, your eyes, and namaste to everyone. I will see you all tomorrow.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.